My name is Nick Leister, and I'm a member of the SolidWorks training team. In this multi-video series, I will show you how to start with SolidWorks as I model a pair of needle-nose pliers. In this video, the sixth in the series, I'll show you how to edit an existing design previously saved to the 3D Experience platform and demonstrate how to pattern a feature. Finally, I'll show you how to apply a new revision to a design. Let's get started. I have SolidWorks open. I'll modify a design, a pair of needle-nose pliers that I worked on recently. To access the needle-nose pliers, I'll click Welcome to SolidWorks, which opens the Welcome pop-up. The Recent Documents section lists the needle-nose pliers, and when I click the model, the pliers open. The Feature Manager flyout menu indicates that these files, opened from my local directory, are synced with the platform, locked, set to revision A, and all use the latest revision. I'll add a straight knurl to the ends of the pliers, which belongs to the handles geometry. Therefore, I'll select the handle from the tree and click Open Part. The handle opens within the part environment. I'll create the straight knurl by patterning a small wedged cut, which I'll model now. Using the tree, I'll select the front plane and click Sketch. I'll center the pattern's first wedge cut on the gripping face. So, I'll click the Line command and select For Construction under Options in the Property Manager. I'll hover the cursor over the edge, pick up on the center point, which displays as a yellow dot, and click to start the line. I'll zoom in further and pick up a horizontal relation. Click to place the end of the line, and click the Escape key on the keyboard to exit the Line command. This entity will constrain the wedge to the center. Now, I'll click Line again and make my first selection on the edge below the center. Click the construction line's endpoint and click the edge above the center to form the rough shape of the wedge. Again, I'll click the keyboard's Escape key to exit the Line command. I accidentally created a perpendicular relation between the two line segments while drawing the lines. Constraining this angle with dimensions instead of relations will allow me to edit the neural cut's shape later if needed. To delete a relation, select it in the view area and click the keyboard's Delete key. Now, I'll define new relations. While holding the keyboard's Control key, I'll click the two line segments, which opens a pop-up with suggested relations. I'll click Equal. The Equal relation defines the two lines with equal length. I'll use the Smart Dimension command to create an angled dimension between the edge and the bottom line. I'll enter 45 degrees and click the keyboard's Enter key. Finally, I'll add a dimension between the two endpoints so the wedge is 1/32 of an inch. This open sketch profile is fully constrained, so I'll browse to the Features tab of the Command Manager and click Extruded Cut. The preview looks good, so I'll click OK. Now, I'll pattern this wedged cut to create a straight knurl. I'll expand Linear Pattern from the tree to show the available pattern types. As you can see, there are many options available for creating patterns. A straight knurl is a pattern that repeats linearly, so I'll click Linear Pattern in this case. The Linear Pattern Property Manager appears. I'll start by defining the pattern's direction. With Direction 1's Pattern Direction field active, I'll expand the Feature Manager design tree and click Top Plane, which will propagate the pattern in a direction normal to the plane, as indicated by the arrow. I'll activate the Features to Pattern field and click the Cut Extrude feature from the tree. A preview appears, reflecting the default inputs at the top of the Property Manager. With the Spacing and Instances option active, the feature provides inputs allowing me to specify the space between instances and the number of instances. I'll activate spacing and enter 1/32 of an inch, the dimension I use to drive the cut extrude sketch. I can use the arrows to drive the number of instances parameter up, but I'll enter 32, which pushes the pattern close to the tip's endpoint while leaving a small flat portion at the end of the face. The preview looks good, so I'll click OK. Let's see how these design changes look within the assembly. The assembly is open behind this part. I could minimize the part and open the assembly, but I'll explore another method. While holding down the keyboard's Control key, I'll click the keyboard's Tab key to display all open SolidWorks files. I'll browse to the needle-nose pliers, and a message will appear asking if I'd like to rebuild the assembly. I'll click yes. The straight knurl looks excellent. Expanding the Feature Manager flyout shows that the assembly and the handle have changed, and all files are locked. I will change the handle's revision and keep the assembly's revision when I save the design, which I will do using the Task Pane's 3D Experience tab. I'll select the needle nose assembly and click Save Active Window from the Lifecycle tab. The Save to 3D Experience window appears. I'll scroll to the right. The needle nose and handle files are listed under the pliers bookmark and set to Revision A. When I scroll further and activate the new revision checkbox for the handle, the file drops its bookmark tag. This occurs because the 3D Experience platform treats new revisions like new parts. The handle's Revision A maintains its link to the pliers bookmark, but I must add a bookmark for Revision B. With the file selected, I'll use the bookmark dropdown and click Select Bookmark, which opens the Select a Bookmark window. I'll expand Hand Tools, activate Pliers, and click Apply to Selected. Now I'll click Unlock Files after saving, and click Save. The needle nose assembly is unlocked and keeps its revision. The handle part is also unlocked, and its revision has been changed to B. The pin remains unchanged, but it's locked. I could unlock the pin from the Feature Manager flyout menu, but I'll use the Task Pane to unlock the pin here. To do this, I'll browse to the Collaboration tab, select the pin, and click Unlock. Now, I'll close the needle nose assembly and the handle part. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this content helpful, visit the site below to access the 3D Experience Platform Users playlist and check out the Beginner's Guide to X Design series.